Hey funky people, today I'm gonna break up my setup for Moontrip. This is a trick a week episode 3. So let's go and let's see what's happening behind me. Check the video Moontrip if you haven't, it's a fun one using all this gear, some new stuff. So let's go. Here we are, the whole setup. Everything is on stands, as you can see, even the hand pan, so that I can play standing. Here we have a Soulshine hand pan that was just doing a little melody in the video. The very interesting Looper Boss RC505. Plug and play, very useful. Of course, it's not a computer, it's not Ableton or something that you could use through a digital mixer, but I like it because it's very light. So to go on a plane, to tour with it is very easy, and it's quite powerful. Of course, it's not perfect. We're missing a few things in this looper, but it's quite nice. So the main instrument in Moontrip was this little kalimba or sensula, but the skin broke up. Sensula has got a skin to make wah-wah effects. So I just kept the instrument itself, very small, once again, practical to go on a plane. And I've been sticking this contact microphone made by Schertler. It's a Dean G. So as you can see, I'm just sticking it. You can stick it closer to this place here. It's going to be a bit more punchy with attack. Or you can go a bit down there on the resonance case and you will get a bit less attack. So I've done something like kind of in between. And actually this kalimba is going straight into the microphone input of the 505, because with the Schertler pickup, I don't need much EQ. It's really magical. You can hear it in the video. It's just plugged in the microphone input and then it works. So I'm saving an input on my mixer using the built-in input, much easier, and this way I have a bit more room on the mixer. I'm an old school guy, so I really like to have all these buttons analog style. Of course, you can use once again Ableton or the last mixer that are Rax mixer done by Behringer, for example, that you control with an iPad or a phone or a computer once again. But I'm like kind of old school and I like to touch things and to have this analog feel, right? So in this mixer, I'm having the 8kg C411 that I put on the hand pan on the rubber ring here. Without a rubber ring, it's very metallic. So, and I'm putting the 8kg in between two notes, right? Usually it's in between the octave and then either the fifth, or in this case, it's the third, but it's totally fine in between. Right, but it's not going to be enough to have a nice handpan sound. So on the second track, I'm using a dynamic microphone, but it could be also a condenser if you really want to have a nice deep sound for your handpan. And the dynamic microphone is pointing at the ding, and the closer it is, the best it is, right? These two, the pickup and the microphones, I'm EQing, of course, most of the time taking out the high mids. On the pickup, I'm really taking out between 2 kHz and 3 kHz, could be 3 kHz. And as you can see here, I'm taking it way down. On the dynamic microphone, I'm doing kind of the same, but a bit less because it's a bit more natural microphone, so it's fine. Then what I've been doing is trying to work with the Hansonic, really fun piece of gear. It's been lent to me by a friend. It's not mine, but it's really nice. It's not the big HPD20, but it's really nice. And this one is actually going directly once again in the 505. In the 505, I have my mixer going on the left mono, and actually the HPD going on the right. It's quite nice because actually I can plug two different sources, one left, one right, and actually I've selected mono inside the looper, so they are both in the center, right? So that's the HPD to do funny beats and all. I'm controlling all this with these headphones, the Bose noise cancelling one, but you can use your preferred headphones, of course. And a few things before I go to the last instrument that I will develop more on the next video. I've been asked, what is this instrument you use with your mouth that seems a bit bigger than a joharp? So this is a bamboo joharp, actually. This one, I think, comes from Bali. I don't really remember. So it's a nice joharp, but it's very short resonance, like very short sustain, but it's nice to do grooves, right? The mixer is going into my, I like, you know, effect pedals. So the mixer is first of all going into this octaver pedal, but I think I didn't use it much on the Moontrip one. I love it on tour with hand pans. I will develop this later in the video. And then into this reverb I really love, Stream on Big Sky. It's totally crazy. You can do a lot of sound design. As you can see, it's a bit rugged and worn out. And when the effect pedals process the signal, then it is going in the looper. Last piece of equipment in the Moontrip video is this Continue MIDI made by Haken. And this one, I will really make a special video about it because it's a new kind of keyboard. If you know the C-board by Rolly, it's quite similar, but this is really, really a new take on keyboards. So it's gonna be in the next video. How do you pilot your 505 while you're playing the handpan? And the trick is to use a foot switch. So this one is the FS6 from Boss. Two foot switches, quite useful, and Zalem Delarbre, great didgeridoo player, beatboxer, and looper guy, advised me to use the A button to select track between first and fifth track. You can select your track. And the B button will be helpful to launch the recording and stop the recording. So you can't pilot every parameter in the 505, but it's really useful with your feet while you are recording. And the rest you have to go with the fingers, of course. So that's it for quite a simple setup, easy to take on tour, quite plug and play. I hope you enjoyed. See you in the next A Trick a Week video. Bye bye, guys.